So hydrosphere, Nana, the lesson hydrosphere. So we have to discuss first of all about the some important keywords, Nana. So in this keywords, Nana, what is meant by stream? A stream means the ocean current. Stream means the ocean current which flows speedily is called a stream. The ocean current which flows speedily is called a stream. Next one, drift. The ocean current which flows very slowly is called as a drift. So what are meant by ocean currents? The general movement of a mass of water in a fairly defined direction over a great distance is called as a ocean current. So next, Nana, transpiration. A considerable proportion of water vapor is released into the atmosphere by plants through a process is called the transpiration. Salinity. So in the last class, I have told you many times, Nana, what is meant by salinity? The total content of dissolved salts in the seawater is called salinity. The total content of dissolved salts in the seawater is called salinity. Next, El Nino and La Nino. So El Nino and La Nino. What is meant by El Nino and La Nino? So see here, Nana, the effects caused by the change in the hydrosphere in the Pacific Ocean is called as El Ninos and La Ninos. El Nino and La Nino effects caused the changes in the temperatures. The effects caused by the changes in the temperature in the Pacific Ocean is known as El Nino and La Nino. See the next slide, ma. So here also, centrifugal force. Centrifugal force means, actually it is a physical science term, Nana. This is a term related to physical science. What is meant by centrifugal force? The radially outward force on a body in uniform center motion observable only in a rotating frame of reference is called as a centrifugal force. Next, hydrological cycle. So in the previous class, we have discussed about the hydrological cycle, Nana. The cyclic process of water from ocean to land and then from land to the ocean is called hydrological cycle. Hydrological cycle, there are six stages in the hydrological cycle. We know the six stages, Nana. What is that? Evaporation. Next one is transpiration. Third one is the condensation. And the fourth one is precipitation. And fifth one is runoff. And sixth one is groundwater. So next, Ma, what are oceans? One more questions, Nana. So these are also very important for all of you. So what are oceans? The huge water bodies are called oceans. The huge means large. The huge water bodies are called oceans. So what is the largest ocean on the earth? The Pacific Ocean is the, which one is the largest ocean on the earth, Ma? The Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean on the earth. How many stages are there in the water cycle? There are six stages. Now only we have discussed. Okay, there are six stages in the water cycle. What is evaporation? The process by which water changes from liquid to gas is called evaporation. The process by which water changes from liquid to gas is called evaporation. Express the hydrological cycle in a mathematical equation. So here RF is equal to RO plus ET. RF means rainfall. It is equal to RO means runoff plus ET means evapotranspiration. So what is that, children? RF means rainfall. So it is equal to RO. RO means runoff and ET means evapotranspiration. So this is all about the mathematical equation form of a hydrological cycle. Okay, let us move on to the one more, Nana. So here we have the given the description for the mathematical equation of hydrological cycle. RF is equal to rainfall, RO is equal to runoff, and ET is equal to evapotranspiration. So where is the Indian Ocean? Indian Ocean is to the south of Asia. Indian Ocean, where is in Indian Ocean, Nana? Indian Ocean is located south of our south of our country also. What are the first order relief features on the earth? So do you know where, what are the first order landforms on the earth, Ma? Oceans and continents are the first order relief features of the earth. Oceans and continents are the first order landforms or relief features of the earth. So mention the cause that leads to the formation of ocean currents. Mention the causes that leads to the formation of ocean currents. So there are four important causes that leads to the formation of ocean currents. Ocean currents anevi erpatu avadaniki ee four reasons anevi kaaranam anamata. So ee four factors, one is the centrifugal force, second one is the effect of winds, third one is the effect of precipitation, and fourth one is the effect of solar energy. These four effects caused the formation of ocean currents. Which is the ocean that encircles Australia? Which is the ocean that encircles the Australia? I mean, Australia is surrounded by the Pacific Ocean. Give two examples of cold currents. One is the Labrador current. Two examples here. I have asked you, Nana, but I have given the four examples here. The Labrador current, the Greenland current, the east wind drift, and the west wind drift. These four examples, these are the four examples for the cold currents. Let us move on to the another slide. So here some, I have prepared some blanks. Dash is a cyclic resource. So what is cyclic resource here? Hydrological cycle or water cycle. The answer is hydrological cycle or water cycle. Okay, losing water vapor to the air by plants is called. Losing water vapor to the air by plants is called. So in your biological science, you know this term. What is that? Losing water vapor to the air by plants is called. What is that, ma? Transpiration. So forming tiny droplets and clouds by water vapor is called. Forming tiny droplets and clouds by water vapor. Precipitation. Okay, chemical name of the common salt is sodium chloride. Chemical name, what is the chemical name of the common salt, ma? Sodium chloride. Salinity of ocean is expressed as ppt. Salinity of ocean is expressed as ppt. So the full form of ppt is parts per thousand. The full form of ppt is parts per thousand. The average salinity of the ocean is 35%. The average salinity of the ocean is 35%. River water contains how much percentage of sodium chloride? River water contains how much percentage of sodium chloride? Here I am giving this question to you only. So you only answer. So I have given the entire percentages of river water, ocean water, okay, briny water, etc. In the slideshow, in the last class, I have shared one PDF to all of you. So you can find that answer from that. The temperature at the foot of the ocean is, this is also. So the temperature at the foot of the ocean is. Largest continental shelf present in. Largest continental shelf present in which ocean, Anna? Pacific Ocean. Largest continental shelf presents in where you can find that? In Pacific Ocean. See the next one, ma. So what is there in the next question? What is there in the next question, Nana? Okay, see the next one, Nana. What is there in the next question? Which dash occupies more ocean area? So which occupies more ocean area, Nana? Either it is continental shelf or what is that? Continental slope. So this is also, you can get the answer from the slide, ma, PDF. Don't share on the screen, ma. Next, world's deepest trench is What is the name of the world's deepest trench, ma? Mariana Trench. That is in the Pacific Ocean. World's deepest trench is Mariana Trench. The answer is Mariana, M-A-R-I-A-N-A. Mariana Trench in the Pacific Ocean. Highest temperature is in Dash Sea. Highest temperature is in Dead Sea. So dash is the circulation of water in different forms. What is ma? What is the answer for this? Dash is the circulation of water in different forms. Ocean currents. So dash are the flattest and smoothest regions of the world. Which areas are the flattest and smoothest regions of the world? So the plains. Lowest salinity is found in. Lowest salinity. Where you can find the lowest salinity. So let us move on to the next slide, ma. Here, objective type of questions are there, ma. Dash percentage of total water on the earth is saline ocean water. How much percentage, nana? Dash percentage of total water on the earth is a saline ocean water. So what is that? 97.25%. Which ocean separates Asia and Oceania? Which ocean separates Asia and Oceania? So the answer is a see here, Nana. The Pacific Ocean, ma. Which ocean separates America and Europe? America and Europe, Nana. So that is the Atlantic Ocean. Which of the following consists the highest salinity? So highest salinity contains by what is that, ma? Lake Van and Dead Sea. Next, which of the following consists the lowest salinity? So lowest salinity is Hudson Bay. Hudson Bay, ma, B-A-Y. The line joining the points in the ocean having the same degree of salinity. So the answer is isohalines. The line joining the points in the ocean having the same degree of salinity is isohalines. First successful worldwide deep sea exploration was conducted with first successful worldwide deep sea exploration was conducted with Challenger. The answer is D, ma, Challenger. Next, oceanic temperature range is, see the A, nana, minus 2 degrees to 29 degrees centigrade. Minus 2 degrees to 29 degrees centigrade. Submarine canyons are observed in. Where is the submarine canyons are there in the deep sea plains? So what are very significant in the study of plate movements? What are very significant in the study of plate movements? So continental shelves. So here 11th one is the identify the odd one. Sodium chloride, common salt and table salt and calcium chloride. So which one is the hard one here? Odd one here. Sodium chloride and common same thing and table salt. So first three are the salt. Calcium chloride. This one is the odd one here. So identify the odd one means calcium chloride. Transporting water from the atmosphere to the surface of the earth. Transporting water from the atmosphere to the surface of the earth is called as a precipitation. Transporting water from the atmosphere to the surface of the earth means it is rainfall. So rainfall happens with the process of precipitation. Dead Sea is in. Where you can find Dead Sea? So whether it is in Turkey or Israel or it is in USA or Japan. So here the correct answer is Israel, ma. Somebody is unmute, Nana. Please be in mute, ma. Shweta. Okay, Shweta, please be in mute, ma. The single super ocean was known as, 14th one is the single super ocean was known as. So what is the single super ocean, ma? Panthalassa. So single super continent means it is Pangaea, and single super ocean was known as Panthalassa. All of you please remember the difference between the Pangaea and Panthalassa. Pangaea means the single super continent and Panthalassa means the single super ocean. So here also find the odd one. So here the stages of a hydrological cycle were there, ma. So observe that first one, A is evaporation, B is condensation, C is salination, and D is precipitation. So here one word is not related to the six stages of water cycle. So what is that mean? Salination. Here the odd one is a salination. Evaporation, condensation, and precipitation are related to the water cycle. They are the stages of water cycle, but salination is the different one. So here the odd one is answer is a salination. So here I have given some matchings for you, ma. So group A and group E, are there some words are there, ma? So all of you observe that. Average salinity of the oceans. So the answer is D. What is the average salinity of ocean? 35%. Okay, highest salinity is found in Lake Van. E is the answer. And the lowest salinity is found in Hudson Bay. Next, salinity is expressed as PPT, parts per thousand. The deepest trench is Mariana. It is in a Pacific Ocean. So the average salinity of the oceans is 35%. The highest salinity is found in highest salinity is 35% or 35 parts per thousand grams of water. Highest salinity is found in Lake Van. Lowest salinity is found in Hudson Bay. Salinity is expressed as a PPT, ma. PPT, parts per thousand. The deepest trench is Mariana Trench in the Pacific Ocean. So let us see the next one, ma. See the next one once. The single super ocean. The single super ocean. What is the single super ocean? That is Panthalassa. Single super ocean is a Panthalassa. See the next one. Isohaline. Isohaline means the lines that connects the points on the seabed at an equal vertical distance. So here one more important E is also, look at that, the line that connects the points with the same degrees of salinity. So what is the right answer here? Either C or E. So here the answer is E, ma. The lines that connects the points with the same distance, the same degrees of salinity. Okay. Isohaline means the lines that connects the points with same degrees of salinity. So this one is a right answer. So don't get confused, Nana. Here, C and E are looks like same, but E is the right answer here. Okay, next one. See that isobath. So isobath are also given here. So isobath, the correct answer for isobath is C. The lines that connects the points on the seabed at an equal vertical distance. So next, see the plants. So plants, transpiration. So what is a transpiration? Plants releases water, or plants leaves the water into atmosphere. It is called as a transpiration. So next, Mahatma Gandhi. So one word is given here that is related to Mahatma Gandhi. What is that word? So option B is right answer. Dandi. Dandi, Nana, not Dandi. Dandi is the right word which is related to Mahatma Gandhi. Why? Because means Mahatma Gandhi conducted salt satyagraha in the place of a Dandi. So at the time of British rule in India, he moved on to conduct a salt satyagraha at Dandi. Dandi is a small village which is situated at the Arabian Sea, near to the Arabian Sea. Okay. Next one, see that. So here I have given you one work, ma. Draw the hydrological cycle and mark the stages involved in it. Here, the important work. This is a project work to you. All of you, draw the hydrological cycle neatly in your notebook and mark the six stages of a hydrological cycle. Six stages means evaporation, transpiration, condensation, precipitation, runoff, and groundwater. These are the six stages you know well. So all of you draw this, okay? So these are the worksheets prepared for your practice. Okay, all of you check once how much content knowledge you have understood from the chapter number 3, okay?
Okay.
Okay, next, Nana. Once again, we will check the blanks also. Percentage of total water on the earth. Sorry, Nana, not blanks, object type. I think have you all marked correctly the object type bits, the answers for the object type bits. And let us see the blanks also at once, ma. Which one is a cyclical resource? Means the water cycle is a cyclical resource. Okay. Next one, losing water vapor to the air by plants is called the transpiration. Answer for this is a transpiration. Forming tiny droplets and clouds by water vapor is called as a condensation. Chemical name of the common salt is sodium chloride. Salinity of the ocean is expressed as ppt, parts per thousand. The average salinity of the ocean is, what is that? 35%. Next, river water contains dash percentage of sodium chloride. River water contains 2% of sodium chloride. River water contains only 2% of sodium chloride in it. So that's why we are using the river water for drinking purpose. River water is fit for human consumption. Next one, the temperature at the foot of the ocean is, the temperature at the foot of the ocean. So what is the temperature, ma? So -2 degrees to 29 degrees. -2 to 29 degrees. Next, largest continental shelf present in, largest continental shelf present in, where we can find the largest continental shelf? It is in the Siberian shelf, ma. It is in the largest continental shelf is in Siberian shelf, that is in the Arctic Ocean. The largest continental shelf, it is Siberian. Its name is Siberian shelf. We can find it in the Arctic Ocean. It is stretching to 1500 kilometers of width. See the next one. Which one occupies more ocean area? Which one is occupied by? Which one occupies the more ocean area? So we have discussed about the continental shelf, continental slope, and deep sea or abyssal plains and oceanic deeps are trenches. Okay. So which one is occupied the more ocean area? Oceanic deeps and trenches. And next, world's deepest trench is Mariana Trench. Highest temperature is in dash sea, Dead Sea. Dash is the circulation of water in the different forms. So sea waves and ocean currents. So which are the flattest and smoothest regions of the world? So deep sea plains are the abyssal plains. They are gently sloping areas in the ocean basins. These are the flattest and smoothest regions, Nana. Deep sea plains. Deep sea plains are the flattest and smoothest regions of the world. Lowest salinity, we can find lowest salinity is in. So highest salinity. So children, remember once, Nana. Highest salinity is found in Lake Van in Turkey and Dead Sea in Israel and Great Salt Lake in USA. these three are the examples for the highest salinity water bodies. So once again, I will repeat the names of the three: Lake Van, that is in Turkey; Dead Sea is in Israel; and Great Salt Lake in USA. These three are the examples for the highest salinity water bodies. And next, which places are consisting lowest salinity? So lowest salinity is found in Baltic Sea and Hudson Bay. So these two are the examples for the lowest salinity in the water bodies. One is the Baltic Sea, second one is the Hudson Bay. Okay, so after this I have explained the important keywords and one mark questions, and also the blanks and multiple choice questions and matchings also. So I think hope you all understood. So all of you fill the answers with a pencil. By using pencil only, fill up the answers, ma. If there is any mistakes in your notes, I will correct it when you come to school. Is there any doubts regarding the worksheets? Is there any doubts, ma, regarding the worksheets, Nana? The percentage of total water on the earth, that is saline ocean water, means 97.25%, ma. 97.25%. Okay, 2.75% is fresh water. The greatest portion of the fresh water is 68.7%. So here, don't get confused about the percentages, Mana. Somebody of you have already taken the textbooks from the school. Once all of you open the textbook and get the percentages well. Page number 20. Textbook, Ma. Okay, is there any doubts, ma?
No, ma'am.
Is going to be
no, ma'am.
Is there any doubts, ma?
No, ma'am.
Okay, Nana. All of you and see the keywords, ma.
Okay, madam.
The single super ocean was known as Panthalassa. Okay, ma. Hydrological. How many stages are there in the hydrological cycle? Means six stages, Nana. All of you once draw the picture of hydrological cycle, that is in your textbook also in page number 28. And the PDF is there, no, which I have shared to all of you. So in that PDF,